It was no accident. Me finding you. Someone had a hand in it. Long before we ever
in the waters of baptism, Carmen Pauline died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
come here together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our brothers and sisters that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation, and that he may take Polly home to himself. Let us pray. O God, you delight in us. You are the water for our thirst and manna in our desert as we travel through the journey of faith through our lives. We praise you for the life of Polly and bless your mercy that has brought her suffering to an end. Now we beg that same mercy to raise her to new life. Strengthen our hope that, nourished by the food and drink of heaven, she may rest forever in the joy of Christ our Lord. Amen. So now, please be seated for readings from Sacred Scripture.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm response is, "The Lord is my light and my salvation."
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. One thing I ask of the Lord, this alone I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple. The Lord is my light and salvation. Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Please stand. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. But Thomas said to him, Master, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay, please be seated. In our American culture, there is a great fear of death. We avoid it. The coronavirus has got death in prominent view, and there's a great deal of fear. But it's not something new, it's just a highlighting of a long-standing thought in our culture. We don't use the word death even. We invent euphemisms to speak of it. We say, I work in hospice care a little bit, part of a music group that does hospice music for the folks. And in that culture, they use, he's in transition. That's kind of a new and different one. But we all say, he's no longer with us, or she has passed away. You know, we avoid even the word. So it's not too different in this passage from the Old Testament that we heard. Their passing away was thought to be an affliction, and they're going forth to be utter destruction. But they are in peace. This passage comes from about 100 BC in time, and belief in life after death was a brand new thing, relatively. For most of the 2,000 years of Jewish history, there was no such belief. It was this life, and you lived on by way of your progeny, your offspring. But it's the voice of Jewish wisdom to finally announce that she is in peace, or they are in peace, those who have died. Well, if that's the case in Jewish thought, how much more under the new covenant we have in Jesus Christ have we reason to hope? Jesus came, God's own Son. He died upon the cross for us to pay for our sins. He rose from the grave. He's alive. His own disciples, the 11 who remained, talked with him. They ate with him. They touched his risen body with the nail marks still visible. He invited Thomas to put his finger there. But they were fully healed. No longer painful but rather signs of his victory and his glory. So Jesus then, who conquered death, promised to go and prepare a place for us and to come back again and take us to himself, so that where he is, we also might be. This involves a transformation of our earthly bodies to be fully healed and alive, so that they're able to be there with him where he is. And like the disciples, we're probably asking, how? And his answer is, I am the way. Jesus himself is the way. St. Paul, speaking to the Romans, says that the children of God did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but a spirit of adoption. We are God's sons and daughters. So we have a great hope that Pauli is at peace with him. Now, from the obituary, I understand Pauli taught religious education classes at Sacred Heart. That was an important thing for her. In fact, she wants money donated not to go for flowers, but to go to religious education, because that was something that was really important to her. And I suspect it was important so that the kids and so that all of us would know the truth of Jesus Christ and thus have the hope that she had. This hope permeated her, didn't it? You could see it in her art, in her sewing, her baking, her gardening, in her reading. And I suspect you could really see it in her loving her grandkids, right? Okay. In all of her living, her hope shone forth. She wanted us all to have that same hope. Stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Pauli received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our sister was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. family and friends of Polly seek comfort and consolation. Lord, heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of our Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And together, let us pray as our Savior himself taught us to do. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. May thy kingdom come and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. So trusting in God, we have prayed for Polly, and now we come to the last farewell. We are in sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day she will see us again and we will enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of heaven. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We sing this song of farewell. We won't actually sing it, but... Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. And we reply, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Polly, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sin she's committed through human weakness, and in your goodness grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so now let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend. We've known each other since we were 9 or 10. Together we've climbed hills and trees, learned of love and ABC, skinned our hearts and skinned our knees. Goodbye, my friend, it's hard to die when all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in the air, pretty girls are everywhere. Think of me and I'll be there. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the hills that we climb were just seasons out of please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family. You tried to teach me right from wrong. Too much wine and too much song. Wonder how I got along. Goodbye, bye, pa, it's hard to die. When all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in the air. Little children everywhere. When you see them, I'll be there. We had joy, we had fun. We had seasons in the sun. But the wine and the song, like the seasons have all gone. We had joy, we had fun. We had seasons in the sun. But the wine and the song, like the seasons have all gone. Goodbye, Michelle, my little one. You gave me love and helped me find the sun. Every time that I was down, you would always come around and get my feet back on the ground. Goodbye, Michelle, it's hard to die. When all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in the air. With the flowers everywhere. Wish that we could both be there. We had joy, we had fun. We had seasons in the sun. But the stars we could reach were just starfish on the beach. We had joy, we had fun. We had seasons in the sun. But the stars we could reach were just starfish on the beach. We had joy, we had fun. We had seasons in the sun. But the wine and the song, like the seasons have all gone. All our lives we had fun. We had seasons in the sun. But the hills that we climbed, you see.
Our sister has gone to rest in the peace of Christ, and now we will bless the ground and commit her ashes to their final resting place. We will also pray for ourselves and for those who mourn that one day we will meet together again. We read in Scripture, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." Our Lord Jesus Christ, by his own 3 days in the tomb, hallowed the graves of all who believe in him. And made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal remains. So with holy water, we pray, bless this ground and make it holy. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in the light of your face, she will see light and know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. In the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Polly and commit her remains to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. May the Lord bless her and keep her. May the Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. And let us pray . Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints, we pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Our sister was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of Polly. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life be our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. And with longing for God's kingdom to come, let us pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. May thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord God, whose days are without end and whose mercies are beyond counting, keep us mindful that life is short and the hour of death unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days on earth in the ways of holiness and justice, that we may serve you in the sure faith, strong in hope, perfected in love. And when our earthly journey is ended, lead us rejoicing into your kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. And except for you guys in the chairs, I guess everybody is standing. So bow your heads and let us pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And in time, may he gently wipe every tear from our eyes. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ.